Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. I've discovered some amazing new Figma plugins, from AI plugins to animation plugins to some plugins which will help you build your own design plugins. Today I have something for everyone. Watch till the end and see how these design plugins can change your design process forever. All right, so the first one we're looking at is called Ugic AI. And this tool allows you to generate UIs based on design systems that you have in Figma. So you can have the material design system or HIG or even a third-party custom design system. You can load it up onto this and it will create design screens based on your design system. What's cool about this is that you can use your own very own components or someone else's components and create a custom sort of AI for yourself. An additional feature is that you can actually do multi-language UI designs. So if you want your UI designs to be displayed in Japanese, Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English, whatever language you can think of, this probably will be able to create that for you. It's able to generate both web and app UI designs. So you can specify which one you are looking out for. And they also have their own component libraries that they've made. So you don't really have to insert material design or HIG. You can use theirs, which again, are very neat, clean, and very direct. It also has a special feature where you can enter the requirements of your client or your own requirements from the design. It will filter it and show you exactly what it's going to create before it creates it. This helps you decide whether you want to go ahead with the design before you're actually designing it. It also helps you kind of tweak things before it goes for design or before it generates design. Much like tools like Relume, you can actually change the page structure through a nice little tree, so as to say. So you can basically just replace one section with the other. You can change aspects of each section based on text and prompts. So each section of a page can be like AI generated, or it can also be tweaked. The only problem with this plugin is that right now the developer is facing some issues. So the plugin, some of the plugin functionality is limited and you need to ask for or request for an invite, etc. All right, so the next one in the AI collection is TypeBalance. And for this, you don't need any invitation or anything. Now, this is perfect for not only beginners, but also people who want to get the perfect balance between different size of fonts, the space between title, subtitle, paragraph, etc., letter spacing, line height, etc. You want to get it perfect based on the kind of typography you have on your page or project. It can detect how the letters are looking on screen, whether the spacing is correct or not. And honestly, these small changes can make a huge difference. It also has a dark background and light background support. So if you have a dark mode, it will do letter spacing and typography based on the dark mode. According to the developer, they are focusing on readability, letter spacing and line height to make sure that your website or your app looks great and is also accessible by users. What's great about this plugin is that it's just one button. It just works. Select the layer, the text layer, and it will do the rest for you. And you'll be able to see the difference. You can see the difference in the video, of course, behind me, but you'll be able to see the difference. And boy, it looks really nice. This is great for people who want to save time or are straight up beginners and they're having trouble with their typography. All right, talking about aesthetics, Animate It by Vijay Verma is such an amazing tool. So simple, yet so useful. Animate It, just simply you select a shape or a layer, and via this library, you can add a bunch of different animations. Each animation is actually pretty nice and it's very useful for your day-to-day UI design work. So it's not just fancy animations. It can be usable and it can be showcased in prototypes as well. And each of these animations converts it into like a smart component. So if you have like a button and you want to add this animation, it will create a component out of that. So you can just copy and paste the button anywhere in your project and it just follows this animation. It actually will help you scale with these animations as well. These components get saved in your library. Again, I love how some of these plugins are just straightforward and easy to use. There's no fancy jargon or expensive plans, etc. Now, I've always dreamt of having my own Figma plugin. In fact, I made a video on creating a design tool of my own using AI. But something like that is finally in Figma. It's called Artifig AI. And it turns whatever you want, your ideas, your goals, into an actual plugin for Figma. Again, you need zero coding according to the developer of this. And how it works is very simple. You just type in a prompt describing the plugin that you want. What does the plugin need to do for the user? Or for example, this developer has created a PDF to image or PDF to layer converter in Figma using this AI tool, and it creates a basic UI for you, so you can always work on making the UI more fancy. But it creates a basic UI, it does the task or the job perfectly for Figma. And a lot of use cases is shown, rotate, 3D rotate, skew, etc. Plugins for PDF import. And it also has a lot of pre-made plugins made by the community here. So it has a community tab. You can see what other people are creating and maybe just copy that plugin for yourself or use it for yourself. You can even adjust the plugin. So if you feel that the plugin isn't working exactly like the way you want it to, or it should have an additional feature, you want to edit or omit something, you can do that via AI as well. Just add another prompt over the top of whatever you've created and it'll create or fix all the issues that you want. You know, often I just open up Firefox right next to my Figma and I have to go back and forth. Now to browse while inside Figma, you can use this plugin called In-App Browser. And all it does is in design mode or even in FigJam or dev mode, you can open this plugin up. Right there is a URL bar. You click on the URL bar, type in a URL or paste something, and it easily just browse whatever you like. It's a very well-designed, simple plugin, dark mode, of course. Now, the only issue with this plugin is there are some websites which I could not access, like YouTube, because they have restrictions on embedding their website on another website, essentially. So here, it's not being able to pull that website onto Figma. Of course, that's for security reasons, that for 100 other different reasons. But a general amount of websites work, and it could be useful for some of you guys, while you don't have to open a separate browser to browse stuff. I'm a huge fan of effects in Figma, creating special effects for text, for images, for shapes. Ruri Shader is a new plugin from the Ruri plugins collection. And they've added these really cool metallic shaders for any shape that you like. So if you import an icon or a logo, you can even add this shader to that. And they've created some really cool, almost hypnotic metallic shader. Some of these look as if Apple made them. And this could literally be in like an advert, in my opinion. But I think a really cool plugin, easy to use, has a lot of customization. You can choose what kind of colors you want also, so you're not stuck with just metal. You can maybe create like a ripple water effect or something in this. And you can even find ways to animate this or find ways to use this in buttons and text, etc. And of course, since it is a Figma plugin, you can do all the editing inside Figma later on. You can turn it into anything that you like. You can edit the layers, etc. So I think that's pretty cool. Talking about straightforward plugins, this plugin is the most straightforward plugin in the world, and it does something that every designer wants. It converts any page that you have. It could be a web page or it could be an app page. You can insert it into any device frame in one click. You don't have to select from those hundreds of cool design mockups. This just brings in a simple device frame, a simple mockup, and that's it. That's all it does. And it has a bunch of new devices, from all Apple devices to, you know, just general laptop, etc. Takes like 1 second, and that's just amazing. Other mockup plugins take like 5 seconds to search, to select the perfect one and then insert it. This just does it in a jiffy, and that's what I love about this plugin. Kudos to Mike for creating this, being an individual developer on this. I think that's really cool. Now, Parallax animations can have a lot of use, from keeping the users engaged to making the mouse or the movement experience a lot more fun. Shapelax takes this to the next level. You select a bunch of frames. It creates these beautiful looking interactive parallax animations based on your mouse movement. So if you have like this character and you want the eyes to move or the body to move based on your mouse, you just select two or three layers, edit the design slightly, and based on those two or three edits, it will change between those edits, almost as if it's animating between those edits based on your mouse placement. So if your mouse is at the right, it will face the right, or it will face a direction that fits the animation. There are a lot of examples that the developer has made or shown. Text-based animation, so titles can float up and down like this. There are characters or, you know, animals, etc., that will look towards your direction. So you can always set four directions, have four directions of that character, and let this plugin animate it for you. You also have nice little background effects. So gradient, background gradient effects. You have this glass effect. You have a lot of other cool effects that you can add with Shapelax. Unfortunately, some of these features are paid. However, I suggest If you're using it for private use or your student, just screen record the result. Just screen record it and you have the final result with you. But on the other hand, if you want to support the developer, I would highly suggest doing that by buying the plugin. It's a one-time buy, so you don't have to get a subscription, which almost everyone hates. I personally do as well. If you guys have been on this channel for more than a year, you know how much I love my icons. And this next icon pack has a Figma plugin, which is just perfect. Works amazingly well. It's called Neaticons. And this Neaticons has some of the softest looking icons, which I like a lot. It has this friendly vibe to it, which a lot of users also prefer. They have six total styles, so line, bold, fill, tone, etc. And I think this works perfectly for almost everyone. Some of these icons, like the magic wand icon, is so unique, it's so different from the other icon packs that I'm sure you'll find some use for this. The plugin itself works really well. You can quickly switch between the designs or styles. You can select between categories and even search for whatever you like. I love the 23,000 plus icons. It's quite a large library. A couple of years ago when I was working for companies, sometimes we had to work on design systems and it took hours to get everything correct. Figr Identity cuts those hours or maybe days into maybe like 20 minutes. It's called Figr Identity and it generates a design system with AI. So it scans your entire design file in Figma, no matter how cluttered or unorganized it is, like most of us are. It creates this very well-organized, almost material design-esque design system out of whatever design system that you guys have currently. It diversifies and tags each color, each layer, button, card, etc. Even the typography, it does pretty well, just like you would find in a standard design system. And it also adds design tokens for not only your Figma needs, but also when developers use dev mode or any third-party tool through Figma, it'll be very easy for developers to identify some of these, the fonts and the colors, etc. So design tokens, they're a must, and this implements it in like a couple of seconds. It also creates comp, names them, and just creates something that you can show to your design manager. You won't shy away. And this will be done in like half a day. They also have their own pre-made custom assets. So if anything's missing from your design system, you can always get it from here. I think all-in-one tool for your design system needs inside Figma. I mean, that's it for today, guys. If you have any suggestions on what plugins I should review next or what video ideas I should include on the channel, let me know in the comments. Hit the like button if you like this video. That helps me make more just like this. And if you don't want to miss out, the best way is to turn on all notifications from the little bell icon. And I'll see you next week. Until next time, take care. God bless.